question.
Benjamin starts to fly his kite.
Hey, he's serious. Alright, so. Sing a happy song. Oh, look, a lightning bolt coming really fast.
My kite is broke.
Oh, yeah, I'm still my part. Oh, no. My hair's all crazy. I could have called it a ting and went twisty.
So Benjamin Blinken went to work and he worked harder than Trump once on his way. Oh wait, this is the past.
Joey, it's your part, by the way. Well then, fix it. Cause technical difficulties. Okay. Just.
I got this. We worked harder than Jack Marsh ever did.
Oh, you got roasted!
Dang, you're roasted.
That was stupid!
That was pretty bad.
Stop looking around, Benjamin Franklin, who is way skinnier than and shorter than the normal actual Ben, but whatever.
That's over. We're not in the ring anymore. We're in the laboratory where he's like building things. Okay, so it took me 15 years and lots of build. Actually, I don't know if he failed or not, I just guessed. But I knew it did take him lots of years. It took him 15 years. No, no! No!
He's
not seen two yet. It took me 15 years and a lot of fails, but I finally done it. I made something that can protect people for the rest of their lives. I shall name it the Lightning Rod. And no, I totally didn't run out of names. I'm just lazy and just, you know, lightning hits a metal pole, rod, boom. Lightning Rod.
Did you have a hard time thinking of names?
No.
So yes. Now you know what actually happened.
And sadly, this is the end of scene one, but we do have another very soon. So let us bring out our ring girl, Amina.
Hold on.
Well, yeah,
scene two.
This is great. This is the best play ever.
Is there another scene?
Yes.
Whoa, did you just say?
Yes.
It took place during 1782 and 1786. Benjamin Franklin was surrounded by the founding fathers. He waited for his turn to sign the Article of Peace and the Treaty of Peace. Benjamin Franklin, John Jay, Henry Lawrence, James Monroe, George Washington, Alexander Hamilton, Thomas Jefferson, and John Adams were all gathered at Hotel de York in Paris.
All of the founding fathers lie in wait to sign the Article of Peace and the Treaty of Peace.
Oh, the line for the sign is... Oh, can't you get in the line quickly? This was not... They just made this, okay. Oh, the line to sign the stupid paper was taking too long.
Nobody cares, Benjamin.
Many people noticed Ben's presence and had hope for that.
Oh my lord, is that the crazy old man?
Yes,
indeed. I was just talking not so long ago. He's a very old man. Is that the guy who chased lightning on a horse?
Yes, he is. He's a genius man, Benjamin Franklin.
Nonsense. If he keeps doing what he's doing, he's going to get himself killed.
I don't believe it. Benjamin's not smart, just an old guy with the screw loose.
Alexander Hamilton walked in.
Hey, guys.
Everyone ignored Hamilton.
Benjamin Franklin was re-elected as president of Pennsylvania.
Yay, I am a president. Woo for me. Much happiness. Yeah, I just totally changed it there.
Weirdo.
When do we actually sign the paper?
Signed it already?
Nope.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dude, those are some short. I just told you that.
Ooh. Yes, I do.
Okay.
Yes, you do.
Where's that?
Everyone signed the paper, and then I'm gonna be like,
I signed the paper.
Stop recording him. Or that Venus band.
He didn't get me.
Okay, just make sure George Washington.
Oh yeah, okay, we're done. Okay, we're done. Thank you for watching.
That was great.
Can
play.
I
get
Ringo?
Go one more
odd.
Time.
Woo! That was odd.
Let's have Ringo go one more time.
Start with Mike.
I am Sergeant.
Mike, the narrator.
Lieutenant, but
Theodore Roosevelt, I guess.
Best narrator there is. I am Orville Wright.
I'm Wilbur.
What?
Huh?
What?
Catherine, their sister.
She's Anthony.
She's narrator.
Yeah. Okay. More impulsive than his contemplative, thoughtful older brother, Orville had boundless curiosity and energetically pursued a range of interests. His mind was quick, and he was constantly coming up with new inventions while pursuing the airplane was initially Wilbur's idea. Orville's enthusiasm and optimism were often what had carried them through to the solution.
Wilbur was self-confident, controlled, and of steady demeanor. Never rattled in through or temper, as his father describes him. Highly intelligent, he was a ferocious reader, a talented writer, and a gifted speaker. Outgoing with circumstances required, he could also isolate himself and shut out the world when he chose.
Late one night, blueprints and model gliders lie amongst a small oak table. Wilbur and Orville Wright gawked at them, trying to make adjustments and fixtures to the models which represented the projects of which they were soon going to partake.
Wilbur, I figured it out. It seems as though we should put two rotors on each side of the plane to balance out the machine itself.
You may be right.
Stop fiddling with those wretched models. You're being completely
dumb. Oh, how can you be so heinous?
Catherine Wright always had a mix of emotions as she watched over her two older brothers. Interest, humor, admiration, encouragement, and as of right now, annoyance.
Just leave us to our work. It's completely harmless. We're no boneheads.
Okay. Just think of it. We will be the most famed people in the States in a couple of months.
The problems began when Orville had noticed light tapping. Exerting from the machine itself. After a bit of maneuvering, the propeller snapped off.
Lieutenant, don't worry, it'll be safe.
All right.
I'm going to be flying this machine itself. After
okay.
all, I was the one that built it.
Yeah, it's true, Lieutenant. Let's fly here and we're going to take it through the air.
Okay.
All right, I hope
this works. Please board the machine. All right, now hold on to the front panel bar. All right. Keep your hands and feet in sight. All right.
Stay down!
Oh my god, Lieutenant Sol- Oh yeah, absolutely. Oh my god, Lieutenant Selfridge! My leg's broken!
Oh!
Lieutenant!
Oh, are you okay? Oh! I'm dead!
Go ahead.
Oh, I'm good.
The audience sees that the aircraft took a steep nosedive, and a loud crash could be heard as it made contact with the ground. As everyone came rushing by, Wilbur noticed that Orville was still conscious. As for Thomas, well, he had a gash against his forehead and was definitely not conscious.
But Roosevelt did cross paths with a pilot named Ponce in 1918. That was a part of the Wright expedition team. He thought of the dangers and refused, but later changed his mind. Roosevelt then was the first president to ride in a flying vehicle made by Wilbur and Orville Wright?
What?
Scene. Insane.
Although the two brothers had blood on their hands, we'll always remember them from their goals and courage.
Now, no one was harmed.